New airport. Oh shit. What the? Hold on. I know you lying to talk. You know what? Oh. TikTok, what are you doing? Hey y'all. Hey y'all. New airport, who this? Welcome y'all. Your girl is, first of all, trying to get my thing right. There we go. Okay, your girl is in a new country for the first time in 5 weeks, because I was in Panama for 5 weeks, and now I am somewhere else, and it's not where I told y'all I was gonna be. Excuse me. Now I'm somewhere else, and it is not where I told y'all I was gonna be. I feel like I need to put in my AirPod. Number one, I make sure y'all can hear me, and number two, so I don't look like I'm talking to myself out here. I was literally just telling. Where the hell is my AirPod? Oh, hell no. Where the hell are my AirPods at? Hold the phone, y'all. Hold the phone, because sis about to go off. Oh, I found them. All right. I ain't tripping. I am not tripping. We found an AirPod, y'all. Crises. There we go. Alright, y'all. Could somebody please do me a favor and confirm the document for me? I put in my AirPods, but y'all know sometimes Bluetooth don't be Bluetoothing. So, let me know if y'all can hear me okay, pretty please. Look at those little Pomeranians. I will tell y'all this. I have never seen so many dogs inside of an airport until I came to this airport. So, this clearly, how did I get in here? Okay, this is clearly not how I got in here. I got in here another way. Let me turn around, because where the hell am I at? Thank y'all for the hearts. Please keep them coming. I appreciate it. Welcome, y'all. Start dropping those travel questions. In the meantime, just tell y'all a little bit about me. So, just in case you are new to this space. My husband and I left the United States back in February. Wait, did y'all ever confirm that y'all can hear me? Can y'all hear me or not? Because I swear, sometimes I be live, and then I be talking, and then come to find out somebody be like, oh, we didn't hear what you said. But my husband and I left the United States back in February of this year, and we have been traveling. We are currently in our 9th country of the year, and it's been an incredible journey. And I've been going live, giving y'all the behind the scenes of living abroad, giving y'all the behind the scenes of travel, you know, showing y'all some cool stuff, but also showing y'all the not so sexy parts of travel, because I feel like a lot of travel creators, you know, They quick to show you them beautiful waters and whatnot, but they don't show you all the stuff, okay? So, but if you want to see all sides of travel, definitely hit that follow button. And thank y'all so much for the hearts. Please keep them coming. And drop your travel questions. Also, drop where you are from. Drop where you are located. Let's see who we got in the house right now. Who is in here? We got East Coast. We got West Coast. Southerners, my internationals. I might get some ice cream. Who we got in the house right now? Where y'all from? Drop in the comments. Why everybody being so quiet today? Y'all don't want to talk today? Thank you, XW. You know what? I'm not going to try to say that whole username. But okay, Texas. We got the South in the house. I want to travel to the Philippines. How does the Philippines treat black men? I wouldn't know, because number one, I'm not a black man. Number two, I've never been to the Philippines, but there used to be a guy. You could just call me Wiz. Okay, perfect. That's easy. There was a guy who used to come in my life, and he's lived in the Philippines for years, and he loved it. I would imagine you would be fine, honestly. I mean, I think I can't speak for all Asian countries. I definitely have not been to all Asian countries, but all the ones that I've been to, I have not had any issues, and I've heard really, really amazing things about the Philippines. I actually really want to go there. Y'all, I might get me a pastel de queso because I have not had one of these bad boys since I was in Brazil, okay? And when I tell y'all, your girl loves a pastel de queso, okay? Queso here, but in Brazil, queijo is how you say it. Oh, we got all the empanadas. I'm getting hungry again. Me and my husband split a taco earlier. Not a taco, like a barriga quesadilla thing earlier. Oh my God, y'all, look at the empanadas. Look at all the empanadas, y'all. Look at all the empanadas. I want them. I'm actually making a travel list now. Greece is in my top places. Okay, I have never been to Greece. So you will definitely have to let me know how you like it. I'm showing y'all the airport a little bit because I was telling my husband earlier, I said I should go live in the airport more, I feel like. You can see me. I feel like I airports are a huge problem. Airbnb could not let us in before 3 p.m. We landed at 10 a.m. and it's now 1 p.m. We have been in this airport for a long time now, hanging out, doing nothing. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go live in the airport for the first time. So that is what I am doing now. I should get some cash. That would be the wise thing to do. And yet, I don't feel like it. So there's that. I'm not gonna lie. What are a few countries you've been to? I'm new here. Yeah, no worries. So this year I've been to Brazil, Spain, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia, Japan, China, Panama. Yes. That's where I've been this year. And right now I am in Colombia. So we've been around the block this year. Like I said, me and my husband we're living abroad. So we actually were supposed to be living in Florida right now, fun fact. But then we were like, you know what? Why would we do that? We could just get the fuck out of this country. So we left the country. Vietnam and Thailand, what was your experience like? Those were in the top three of my favorite places I've been this year. Brazil, Vietnam, and Thailand are my favorite places that I've been this year. Obviously Vietnam and Thailand are in Southeast Asia, so those are going to have more similarities than Brazil, but Vietnam and Thailand, some of the most delicious food that I've had in my entire life. Thailand is just a vibe. Like, people don't exaggerate, y'all. Like, I'm going to just tell you right now, people do not exaggerate about Thailand. Do not think it is overhyped, because it's not. Because sometimes I'm the kind of person where, like, whenever I hear so many people talking about something, like, I get kind of like, people probably just saying that because everybody say that. No. Thailand is the only country me and my husband were in. Yeah, we were in Thailand for less than 24 hours. And we were both like, we can see ourselves living here. That's the only time that happened. I'm thirsty. I'm speaking to my husband. Here we go. I'm going to get some of my water from over here. Get him over here. Excuse me, sweetheart. I got thirsty. Yeah. Yeah, I did. Why are you judging me? You're welcome, Wiz. But yeah, so we were going to move to Florida, and then we were like, you know what? We're going to leave the United States instead. And so the thing is, we had already talked about traveling the world. No, well, hold on. Let me bring it back. We had already talked about traveling together for 6 months. We were going to do it in like 2 years, but then y'all, like, you know, the timing just really worked out, to be honest with you. So thank y'all for the hearts. So, first of all, our lease was up, right? So, like, let me just go ahead and preface all of this by saying, me and my husband, we have no kids, we have no pets, and we have no mortgage. So like our lease was up, so we were already kind of like, well, you know, we don't have the house, we don't have, you know, like the house, because we were in like a 3-story townhome. We were like, okay, so we don't have the house to worry about. I'm gonna take y'all upstairs, we go see what's happening up here. We was like, we have no house to worry about. And then we were just like, what are we waiting for? We were like, what are we waiting for? We're like, we have no kids, we have no obligation here. And we were just honestly just kind of sick of the U.S. and just like, you know, a lot of things that comes along with the U.S. The U.S. has a lot of great things about it, but the U.S. also has a lot of shitty things about it, which, you know, we all know, right? And at the end of the day, you could argue like no country is perfect. I get that. But there were just like certain things that we really did not want to. This is kind of cute up here. I mean, it's kind of quaint. But it's just like certain things that you don't want to have to worry about, right? Like, she said, get me out of here. Nina, I feel it. I feel it. Yeah, there's just certain things that you don't want to have to worry about. Like, why are y'all poisoning us with the food? Like, it's, I just, y'all, I'm honestly, like, the food in the U.S. is, it's really crazy to me. Like, it is crazy to me, y'all, because in the U.S., we are so obsessed with, oh, everything needs to be like gluten-free and like carbs are evil and dairy is evil. And you go to these other countries where these people are so much healthier, they're living healthier lives, they're not dying from heart disease and diabetes and all these things, and these motherfuckers are eating bread and cheese and all the things. Like, make it make sense. Honestly, make it make sense. And also, you know, we wanted to live a slower life. Hello, shy social butterfly. We wanted to live a slower life. I got my second passport. I'm here for it. We wanted to live a slower life, right? Like, we wanted to get out of the rat race, and like our mental health has just been so much better since we left the U.S. So yeah. Have you noticed a significance in your weight or energy because of the food? So we were definitely losing weight when we were in Vietnam. Definitely not in Brazil, girl, because child, we were partying like crazy in Brazil. And then we noticed in Vietnam that, like, without even trying, we were just losing weight. And then whenever I was actually visiting in the States in July, we were home for like 5 weeks, and y'all, within a month, because we were in Panama for the last 5 weeks, we literally just got to Colombia today a few hours ago. And I literally told him, we were in Panama for like 3 weeks, and I was like, my clothes are already looser, like, just from like being here. Like, it's yeah, it's crazy. I'm planning to move abroad in 2025. Yes, where are you going? How did you get a residency visa? I don't have a residency visa. What kind of healthcare do you have? I have travel insurance through my credit card. So right now I don't have like regular health insurance, but the travel insurance with the Chase Sapphire Reserve is like phenomenal. And you know, another thing to keep in mind about health insurance, a lot of times outside of the U.S., it's like not nearly as expensive. You know how like in the U.S. you're literally like afraid to go to the doctor and find out what's wrong with you because you're afraid you can't afford it, or like you don't even want to go to the ER. You can't even afford to be sick in the U.S., and which is crazy because sickness is a business in the U.S. It's not like that abroad, right? The healthcare in a lot of places are free, or it's extremely, extremely affordable. So right now we just have the travel insurance. We might look into getting some international health insurance soon, but for now, probably whenever we like settle in one place. But right now, since we're still like traveling around so much, we just use the travel insurance that comes with the credit card. I think Costa Rica, that's a good spot. Lots of expats there. I love Costa Rica. I went there for my honeymoon. I'm going to look into that. I'm here for it. Are you just moving around or in a country and moving around? I don't know if I understood that question. I know what you mean. No, right now we are straight up digital nomading. Like, the longest place we were in Thailand for 9 weeks. We were there for 5 weeks, and we went to Japan for 10 days, and then we came back. But no, right now we are nomading. Like, our plan, I'm like air quoting when I say plan. Our plan is, I want to go downstairs. Oh, there it is. Our plan was to travel for a year, which is this year, and then next year to pick a spot to stay for a year. That is our plan. I'm saying was is. That technically is still our plan. So as of right now, we are still in travel mode. But some of y'all who have been joining me live for several months now know that I have talked about it's amazing, and we've had so many incredible experiences, and I have loved being able to live this life. But at the same time, like, packing up all your shit and moving around a lot it's a lot. So we were in Panama for 5 weeks, which was nice because, like, we really got into, like, a home type, you know. It's literally hotter up there. But anyway, and also, you know, another reason that I left, I mean, I said I left the U.S. because I wanted to live a slower life. And don't get me wrong, like, these other countries, it is easier to achieve that, but is it really a slow life if you're traveling to, like, different countries all the time? Maybe. But I also, you know, I want, like, community. I want to know a neighborhood, right? Like, I want to have a place that I, you know, walk to 3 times a week for breakfast, and they know who I am, and they know my order. I want a community. Like, I want to get to know, like, expats as well. Like, because I always look at black expats in every country I go to now. It's just, like, given. There's a lot of black expats here in Colombia. And so, like, I want that. I want to meet other expats who have decided to, you know, leave the U.S., but I also want to hang out with locals. Like, that's really the main thing, right? Like, if you travel, you go to other countries, I don't want to just hang out with a bunch of Americans all the time. And what I have learned is that meeting locals and hanging out with locals it's not impossible, but it's hard to really build a community and a friendship when you're constantly moving. You know what I mean? There was a couple that we hung out with in Thailand who we do still talk to. And then there was actually a guy that we met also in Thailand. This was in Phuket. The couple we met in Bangkok, but it was a guy who we met in Phuket. And my husband actually just told me that he still, like, hangs out with him or whatever. Or no, he doesn't. Like, he still, like, keeps up with him. But like I said, it's, you know, in order to, like, create a true friendship, you know, you can't be somewhere different every month. So, Mom Teach Travel, thank you for the rose. I appreciate it. And thank y'all so much for all the hearts. So next year, definitely looking forward to, is there anything over here? I feel like I'm just, like, showing y'all hallway. definitely looking forward to staying in the same spot for a year. So right now we are up in the air between Colombia and Thailand. Hey, y'all. And, it's funny because when I say, like, up in the air, so, like, at first we were like, okay, we're going to do Latin America next year. Like, we're definitely going to do Latin America. We want to be close to home. Y'all, we were not expecting to fall in love with Thailand like we did, okay? Like, we were not prepared. We were not prepared to fall in love with Thailand the way that we did. We did not want to leave. And now we're like, fuck, we really love Thailand. We really want to, you know, and now I see why I had this camera turned around. Perdón. Now I see why I had this camera around, because I can't be looking at y'all trying to walk. But anyway, is that escalator? Oh, that's what goes up. I thought it was more stuff down here, but I guess not. I'm going to go back upstairs. We had no idea we were going to love Thailand, so it's been, I'm not going to lie, like, it's been an emotional back and forth conversation, decision, thought process, all of the above, because, you know, we want to be close to our family in terms of, you know, we want to be able to get home. Kippy, I'm moving around right now. I'm not in, like, one specific spot. But, yeah, like, we want to be able to, like, go home. I mean, I know for me, I told him, I said, I want to be able to go home quarterly. Like, I want to be able to go home 4 times a year. My daughters and I love Thailand. I mean, because what is there not to love? I mean, it's, well, like every place, there are some things not to love. It's hot as shit there. That's actually one reason I'm happy to be here, because I looked at the weather and it was like the high was 85, y'all, the high. I was like, oh my God, give me that weather. I am tired of sweating. Although Panama, I will say, like, Panama was actually pretty good in the mornings and in the evenings. One thing I actually don't love about Thailand is, like, I'm not even kidding. Even at, like, 6-7 in the morning, it's already, like, almost 90 degrees. It's like, bro, come on. But yeah, it's been an emotional thought process, decision, all of that, in terms of, like, thinking about being in Thailand longer, because 50% of us is like, you know, that's like a lot farther away from our family. But then the other 50% of us is like, you know, YOLO. Like, we have no kids. Like I said, we have no kids, no pets, no mortgage. And we both know that we love Thailand. And we both are constantly comparing everything to Thailand. And so it's like, why are we not there? You know what I mean? I'm about to sell everything I have. Oh, yeah, girl, we sold. We have one storage unit that's, like, smaller than a bedroom. And we have, like, our clothes. I think I have, like, my computer desk. We have, like, a few things in there. But, yeah, we got rid of our shit. But, yeah, as of right now, we haven't decided. But I don't know. I can't explain it to y'all. Like, sometimes whenever people ask about, like, certain countries that I like or whatever, there's nothing wrong with that. Like, I'm always happy to talk about my experiences. Yes, everything I own is in one room. I'm happy to talk about my experiences. But, and I did a video on this once where I talked about how I feel like something that people don't talk about a lot in travel is, like, just, like, the feelings. Like, sometimes you get to a place and you just feel like, this is where I'm supposed to be at right now. Like, I'm gonna have a great time here. I'm gonna have a good experience here. I'm gonna love it here. And thank y'all for sharing. And thank y'all for double tapping. I appreciate it. Like, sometimes you have that feeling that you can't really explain it. And we had that feeling whenever we got into Thailand. And I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I've been having some feelings like that since we landed in Colombia. And so I think that they're really gonna be going toe in toe in terms of, like, where are we gonna stay at next year. And what I really like about us being in Colombia now is, like, first of all, we're gonna be here until at least November. I'm like, we are, like I said, that shit we did the first half of the year, baby, I gotta, at this point, I'm not interested in staying anywhere. I'm not interested in going anywhere for anything less than, like, 6 weeks. I'm just not. I want to be in a routine. I want to be more settled. But I love that we're here for a few months because, like, it's truly, like, this is going to be, like, the trial for us in terms of, like, because, like I said, even with Thailand, we were there for 9 weeks, but it was split. Like, we stayed in, like, so many different places in Thailand. But for here, we are staying in Medellin. So this is truly going to be the first time that we stayed in, like, one city for this long. So I'm really excited to see. Hola. I'm really decided. That's what happens underneath an escalator? Okay. I'm just really excited to see how it goes and how we feel here. So we'll see. I've been hearing and seeing so many good things about Thailand. Rosa, they're not exaggerating. Thailand is just a fucking vibe. You usually stay in hostels or Airbnbs. In Panama, that was the first time that we rented privately. We actually preferred to rent privately, but honestly, the way that we live our life, it's been kind of hard to do that. Y'all, I told y'all we just got to Colombia a few hours ago. Y'all, I booked this flight yesterday morning. Just hear that again. We booked this flight yesterday morning. I didn't even know we were going to be here right now. We were planning to leave in Panama tomorrow, but the flight was half the fucking price for us to come today. I've been telling y'all about that budget travel tip. Like, people be talking about the best way to find flight deals, and I will be telling y'all for the rest of my life, the best budget travel tip for getting cheap flights is to let the flight prices determine when you fly. So anyway, thank y'all for the hearts. Damn, I really am getting hungry, man. Now I'm looking around like, shit, what can I eat? What the hell was I talking about? Oh, yeah. So, because of the way we be living our life and, like, booking shit at the last minute, not knowing where we're going, it's kind of hard to rent from locals. The other thing is, a lot of locals, like, you can get a way better price than Airbnb. But the problem is, it's, like, 6-month lease, 1-year lease or whatever. And, like, we have not committed to that yet. So that's also another really good thing about us being in Colombia right now, because we are planning on trying out a couple of different Airbnbs in areas that we're interested in, because hopefully if we ended up finding, I know he didn't sleep, y'all. I know he didn't fall, he not sleep. ideally we will find us a place that we love so much that, like, we can tell, you know, the person, like, hey, you know, we're considering staying here all next year. Would you be willing to just, you know, like, rent for us? Because, you know, when you go through Airbnb, obviously Airbnb gets a piece of it, so you charge more. But if you go directly to the person, you don't have to pay that fee. And also, in a lot of Facebook groups, you can see where people have apartments. So we can also be in those groups and kind of see what's available. And we can, you know, be like, hey, we're currently in Medellin. We're thinking about staying here next year. Can we go out and look at it? That's kind of the hard part about traveling so many places and really wanting to find a place that you love, because, you know, it's not like when you're in your hometown that you can just go look in advance. Like, you have to just hope that when you get there, it's going to be good. And that's hard whenever you get in a place and then you got to stay there for 4 weeks, because the last place we stayed at in Thailand, in Bangkok, we fucking hated that apartment. But we had it booked for a month, so what were we going to do? Nothing but stay our asses there for the month. What do y'all do for income? My husband is a personal trainer, corrective exercise specialist, and I am an entrepreneur, so I have multiple streams of income. I primarily do digital marketing and affiliate marketing, but I have like other income streams as well. Would you consider visiting? Oh, and I also have a part-time remote job that I've been doing off and on for 3 years. Would you consider visiting the country before moving first? For instance, I've been eyeing Thailand. So Rosa, I think that what I just said kind of answers your question. That's kind of what we're doing now, because y'all, I don't even know if I guess I didn't mention this earlier. We've both already been to Colombia. This is the first country that we have been to this year where, he's so cute. This is the first country we've been to this year that is like us revisiting. All of the places we've been, we've never been there before. This is the first country that we've been to that we, for the second time. So that's basically what we're doing right now. Like, we chose to come here because we were like, because we really, like I said, we kept having the conversation about Thailand, and we kept just, you know, just kind of like thinking about like, okay, we keep talking about Thailand, we keep reminiscing about Thailand, why don't we just stay there? So that's why we're here in Medellin, because we've already been here before, so we know we like Colombia, but we want to see how we like living here versus Thailand, which we pretty much already know that we love, because we did stay in Bangkok for we did stay in Bangkok for 4 weeks. So yeah, that's what we're doing right now. I just need to work on currently saving to either visit or move there. Yeah. I mean, people definitely move places without visiting. I mean, people even do that in the States, right? You know, you hear about people who like got a job and, you know, they live in North Carolina, but they got a job in Cali. They live in Oklahoma, but they got a job. They got a new job in Florida, whatever the hell it is. Like, you know, people move all the time without visiting a place. At the end of the day, y'all, I think we as humans, we have a tendency to feel like things are permanent. And in reality, nothing is permanent. Like, there are people, like, you know, I talked about, like, me and my husband, we're living abroad. We have no mortgage. We have no kids. We have no pets. Y'all, we know people that have all three of those things and they still make it work. Like, the fact of the matter is, we are all powerful creators, and we can create whatever life we want. So, yeah, depending on what your scenario looks like, you may not be able to go live abroad next month. But if you are serious, if there's something that you want to do, you can make it happen. Because, again, nothing is permanent. So, like, you know, being afraid to move somewhere, that's just, I mean, at the end of the day, that honestly, it's like living your life in fear. Because what is the alternative? The alternative is what? Staying where you are and being... I mean, I'm not even saying being miserable. You ain't got to be miserable, but I have not been outside yet. It's not too bad already. But the alternative is what? Doing what you're doing and not living your life. Like, just living your life on autopilot. Surviving instead of thriving. Like, you know, it's... So you just really got to decide. I've been afraid... To be honest, not gonna lie. I get it. Listen, don't please do not think that we weren't scared. There are days when me and Mel, that's my husband, there are days that we still look at each other like, what the hell are we doing? And you know what? We left in February, y'all. Now it's like September, and we're like, we had no idea what we were gonna be doing. You know, we had planned certain things, but y'all, there's so many things that we planned that didn't happen. So many things. Like, we thought we were gonna spend like a month in Bali. We spent 5 days there. We thought we were only gonna spend 5 days in Bangkok. Ended up spending like 5 weeks there because we loved it so much. We thought we were gonna spend a month in Japan. Saw how much it cost, and we were like, hell fucking no, we ain't doing that. We weren't even planning to go to Panama this year, and we just spent 5 weeks there. We definitely weren't planning to go to Colombia this year. And now here we are. And we never considered staying in Thailand for a year because we said we didn't want to be that far away. And now we're talking about it. I think also being an individual with mental health issues and disabilities, but I'm ready to start traveling, to be honest. I hear you, Rosa. Have you traveled at all yet? Because I was going to say, like, you can baby step it. And, you know, that's another thing I tell people. You know, whenever it comes to travel, start where you are. Like, don't compare your journey to me or anybody else's. Like, yeah, me and my husband left the U.S., but that doesn't mean that the only way for you to travel is to uproot and, you know, leave your entire life behind. Go take a 3-day trip. Go take a 5-day trip. Go take a 2-week trip. Travel with remote year. I talked about I've only traveled all over the U.S. Whereas I have a free guide in my bio for travel beginners, like specifically people who have not traveled internationally before, or maybe if you have but you've only done like resorts or cruises and you want to, you know, like you want to do more. So get the free guide. And obviously you can feel free to ask me any questions. That's amazing. Just allowing the plan to change. Yeah, that's honestly like what we've been, that's what we've just really had to do, because y'all, change is inevitable. Like I said, like we've had a lot of bumps in the road on this journey. Okay, Rosa, let me know if you have any questions. We have had so many bumps in the road in this journey, and we just been working through them. Like that's really it. There's like nothing else for us to do other than to just kind of like get through it and move on. And you know, after going back to the U.S. and being there for like 5-6 weeks, that also made us realize like we don't want to be here. Like it felt good to be home, I'm not gonna lie. It felt good to see our family and friends. I'm not gonna pretend there's nothing good about being in the U.S. But you know, after we were there for a few days, we were like, after we were there for a few weeks, we were like, we gotta get the fuck out of here. What part of Thailand did you love the most? Bangkok was our favorite place, which really, really surprised me, because I thought it was gonna be one of the beach places, but no, it was Bangkok. I am thirsty again. I actually got sick a few days ago. Just like common cold, mucus shit. It's fine. It's just annoying as hell. And I'm like dehydrated all the time. I feel tired, like I'm running out of breath just from this walk. Just from this like walk around the airport. But I appreciate y'all coming over here helping me kill some time, because like I said, we've been in this airport, like y'all, our flight landed at like 10 a.m. It's 2 p.m. here. And because the person who we were doing the Airbnb with, she said that we couldn't check in early because somebody had just checked out today. So we basically just had to wait. You're welcome, Liz. Yeah, we basically just have to wait here. So yeah, we were like, fuck it, I'm about to get some ice cream. I think I'm gonna get some ice cream. And then me and my husband are gonna go downstairs and get us a good old Uber. And we're gonna head to our new Airbnb. But thank y'all again for joining. Hit that follow button if you haven't yet, because I got so much more travel, living abroad stuff coming. And I will catch y'all next time.